Welcome to part one of my video series where I try to take my Robinhood account with less than $1,000 all the way up to $100,000 by trading stocks and options. A few months ago, I made a video about how I turned $1,500 into $62,000 in just 1 month by trading stock options. And I did this back in March when the market was tanking, and the way I made money was by buying put options. And those essentially allow you to bet that stock price will drop in value. One thing I didn't cover in that video was my Robinhood account, which also had some pretty massive gains at the beginning of the year. I ended up withdrawing most of those profits just to ensure that in case the market changed or I just had an unlucky streak, I wouldn't lose all of those profits. But since then, I haven't done a whole lot of trades inside Robinhood, and let's talk about why. Robinhood has exploded in recent years, and they've done it with two key features. First, there are no commission fees. Now, with a normal broker, you have to pay to execute a trade. Well, not with Robinhood. Second, the interface is just unmatched by other brokerages. Mainly, it's super user-friendly for new users. Everything is clean, it's simplified, it's pretty easy to navigate around and start spending money. That's why it's been so alluring to people who are new to the stock market. It's simplified and it's kind of a gamified experience, which makes it kind of addicting. Here's the thing though, Robinhood sucks for options trading. Anytime you try to buy or sell contracts, Robinhood is really slow to fill those orders, not always, but oftentimes, and you end up having to pay more on the buy side or sell for less on the sell side. And the reason why is when you place an order, Robinhood then sends that order to market makers. Market makers are firms that offer quotes for both the buy and sell side of shares and options. They make their money from the bid-ask spread. So when you see that the bid for Tesla is $584.11, that essentially means that's the price someone is willing to pay for a share of Tesla. When you see the ask price of $585, that's basically the price someone is willing to sell a share of Tesla for. So there's an 89 cent difference between the two. Generally, if you're trying to buy Tesla, you'll end up paying closer to the ask, and if you're trying to sell Tesla, you'll end up paying closer to the bid. The market maker profits the difference. Okay, so what does that all mean for you? Well, essentially, if you're trying to buy Tesla, you may have to increase the amount you're willing to pay for it in order to get that order filled on Robinhood, whereas another broker may fill your order closer to the middle of the bid-ask spread, allowing you to save money. So the other brokerage I use, it's a platform called Thinkorswim by TD Ameritrade. Here you pay commissions on options, which amount to 65 cents per contract. To me, it's worth the cost of commissions to get the order filled faster and at a better price. If you look, you can see that I've spent over $1,600 on commissions to TD Ameritrade this year, but in my opinion, it's worth it. And while no brokerage is perfect, Robinhood has had reliability issues where they've been down for an entire trading day, so you wouldn't be able to exit or enter any trades. Oh, and 2,000 Robinhood accounts were accessed by hackers and looted back in October. So, not great. So, you may be asking, why am I using Robinhood then? Well, I've got a little cash sitting in this account still, and I'm willing to make riskier plays to see how fast I can grow it. About 1 month ago, I had just about $700 in this account. Now I'm going to see if I can take that $700 and turn it into $100,000. I will say I got this idea from YouTuber Bia Heza, who is currently trading his way to $1 million. So if you haven't checked out his channel already, I recommend you do that. Also, if you don't understand stock options at all, I did make a video breaking down the basic concepts, which I will link to in the description, or you can click the card that's over up here. So let's go back to my Robinhood account and see what I did in November. On the morning of the presidential election, I bought 5 contracts of ACB, Aurora Cannabis, for $69 per contract. My thought here was a lot of states had legalizing marijuana on their ballot, and if Biden won, there'd be a greater chance of marijuana being legalized nationwide, and this company would benefit. But just after election on November 4th, my account hit a low of $364. But the next day, when it became clear that Biden may win the election, my contracts more than doubled in value from $69 to $162. So I went ahead and sold 3 of them. The next day, ACB shot up even more, and I sold one of my contracts for $630, which is over an 800% profit. And then on the 9th, I closed out my last contract for $690, which is a 900% profit. This brought my account to $1,901.70. I then decided to hop on a Wall Street Bets favorite, NEO. I bought 2 contracts for $149 each. It ended up shooting up that very same day, so I sold one contract for $288, and a couple of hours later, I sold the last one for $340. This brought my account to over $2,200. I then decided to move some money into Bitcoin, so I bought about $1,500 worth of Bitcoin, and then I ended up selling all of it on the 24th for a profit of $203.46. And the reason I sold was to move money into the next Wall Street Bets favorite, Palantir Technologies. Well, I timed it pretty perfectly as Palantir took off like a rocket. The stock price increased 52% just this last week, so this did wonders for my account. Here's a breakdown of the plays. I bought three contracts for $225 on the 24th, and the next day I sold two of them for $400 each. I then bought 10 more contracts for $52 each and sold them for $60 each. And then I bought six more contracts for $416 each and ended up selling four of them for $840 each. So right now, my account is currently sitting at $6,480.80. It's up 156% for the week and 776% for the month. So I'm currently holding one contract of NEO, three contracts of Palantir, and one contract of Fastly with about $2,200 sitting in cash. So just to show you that I haven't made any more deposits into Robinhood, we can see my last activity was in March when I withdrew the bulk of the cash. I am now $93,519.20 away from my goal, so let's talk about what's next. Since Palantir really helped revive this account and I got the idea from Wall Street Bets on Reddit, I'm going to continue sourcing my ideas there, which is super risky, but it's worth a shot. If you have any trade ideas of your own that you want to see me try out for this challenge, leave me a comment, let me know, and who knows, I may do it. Right now I have my eye on GameStop, which I may enter into a trade on Monday, but we'll have to wait and see how the market opens then. Also, one thing I didn't mention earlier when I was ragging on Robinhood is their lack of charting tools. If you really want to get more serious about trading, you should really use a platform that allows you to accurately see candlesticks for different timeframes, along with drawing tools that allow you to mark the charts for technical analysis. Just about every brokerage other than Robinhood allows you to do this, like Webull, which, yes, I do have a link in the description where you can actually get four free stocks until the end of November when you deposit $100. But here on Webull, you can pretty much chart to your heart's content. But generally, I use Thinkorswim for charting and also trading my main brokerage account along with my retirement account. So for this challenge, since I will be trading in Robinhood, I am going to be using Thinkorswim to look up the tickers before I make any moves. This will give me a better idea of the price history along with current momentum. I can also set alerts for key levels on the chart. So if I want to know when Tesla breaks $600, I can set an alert there and then I get a push notification to my phone and also on my computer. So this was obviously a great month of trading and a great way to kick off this challenge. I'll be posting follow-up videos to this challenge probably at least once a month. And in the meantime, I do have some online business experiments that I'm working on, like dropshipping, that I'll be making videos about as well. I'll also be posting some updates to Twitter. So if you want to follow me over there, I'll put the link in the description. Thank you so much for watching. Do me a big favor and hit that thumbs up button on this video. It really helps this channel out. And I will see you next week. Bye.